Assalamu alaikum rahmatullah. Dear viewers, welcome back. We were talking about youth life, inshallah. And now we're going to talk about some solution opportunities as well, inshallah. And, you know, it's fantastic to have young people are giving their views, you know, brilliant. You guys done a lot of charity work as well for OFC. Yep. Can you share us what did you do and who you done it for?
Did projects for human aid. I think it was during Ramadan, we were walking down the streets of London, like hamlets.
How did it feel? Going to people, give
tiring.
Charity
for
it's tiring.
A bit, obviously it's tiring at the end, but I felt good that we actually raised a bit of money. You get a lot of benefit from it, you get a lot of rewards. So at the end, it benefits you and wherever the money is going to the charities.
Did you feel in the first, I'm sure, was it the first time you've done it? Like going to the street and collecting money? First time we've done it before?
Times.
You've done it a few times?
Yeah.
Is it difficult right now get money out of people, man, for charity?
Yeah, it is a bit difficult because you need to be polite. You need to look good. You need to, like, speak nicely. All of that stuff.
Counts
so.
Doing all of that. That's how much these guys are, mashallah, man. They're very mature guys, man, honestly.
Yeah.
Okay, honestly, I've done a few times, you know, going out and, you know, collecting charities for a local mosque and all that stuff, but you're one of them, are you?
What?
Do you go out and do all the charities?
Yeah, I was doing it with him, so we were walking around Tower Hamlets as well, collecting money for Gambia.
Is there any reaction from people? They said something rude to you, oh, is it for you? Or
no, there were a couple of
people. Young people, they might be suspicious, oh.
Yeah.
No, there were a couple of people that didn't want to give. Obviously, that's fine, it's up to you. It's your charity in the day. But I think the whole process was given to us by a senior member of the team. I think Jio and Nazmo, they told us to get involved because it's younger kids. There's another one as well where the local community did a car wash for, I think, human appeal. So we did that. I think there's a lot of younger lot and 15 of us just cleaning cars for the whole day.
MashaAllah, man.
That raised a lot of money. And that was, again, told us to be done by the older people.
Can you imagine who you helped? Can you imagine, subhanAllah, those people you guys helped, actually, they don't have food, they don't have clothes, they don't have anywhere to go. They're probably having food for, I don't know, God knows how many days, you know?
Yeah.
And you just a little thing, you help somebody in another country you don't even know. SubhanAllah, it's amazing, honestly. It's amazing. I think our charities are doing so well. You should be very proud of it. Last 2 years, Muslims are giving in Ramadan the most charitable stuff. We are in that field really, really high. So that is something we should be proud of, isn't it? Especially our sisters, mashallah, they help a lot of money for charities. Masoom, were you in the same team collecting money for charities?
I never did collecting money, but I did do the car wash.
Car wash?
Yeah.
You learn how to car wash now?
Yeah.
You know how to drive, don't
you? Yeah, it was good fun, and obviously the main point was to collect as much money and spread the word, so obviously we did that, and obviously it's a good feeling.
How come our old people, actually, we don't get to see these things? We seem to think all boys are bad. You know, all youth are scary or bad. Or
I don't think they've
something
got
good.
Facebook or Instagram.
And
look
at that boy, his hairstyle and da 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 da. You know, like, they're into these things.
Yeah.
So the things you guys are doing, it. How come people don't know? I'm just quite difficult to get that, man. What do you have to do?
This,
I think, interact.
Okay, when you go out, do you guys do salam first with the older people,
yeah,
or they
yeah,
do salam
yeah.
first to you?
No, I salam the older people first.
I respect you do it first.
Yeah.
Do you expect us to do first, or we expect you to do
first?
It's not my expectation. It's
I know, but
to
it's
be
always
the
Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he used to do first.
True, yeah.
See what I mean? Elders, we do first. That's he's one of the best human beings in the world, and he used to do first. No one can do before him.
It gets, you know, tradition gets mixed up with religion.
Yeah.
You know, culture and religion, they're totally separate things.
Because that could change your life, isn't it? That could change your way. You seen a sasa, assalamu alaikum first, and you say, wow, really? MashaAllah. That young boy actually done salam. And that your ideas or your thoughts are changed straight away. That boy is safe. that, you know, that thing is, that boy is safe.
I think as well.
So he's important, isn't it?
You don't see a lot of the youth in the mosque as well these days. So, of course, there's a lot of older people in there. The older people might think that, you know, these young boys are doing, like, doing something bad. Whereas, like, obviously they might be judging because those kids might be praying at home. But come to the mosque and bring that relationship with the older lot, like, shows you're doing good.
What, have you ever faced, like, as a team, you guys went to the mosque and pray and people were looking at you, what are these doing here? Oh my God.
I think a couple of times.
Any negative?
I think a couple of times, I think it was prayer time and a couple of players wanted to pray. So they came to the change room and prayed. And then while we were getting changed and stuff like that and praying, a couple of members from the other team came in accidentally. Uh-huh. And then they saw us praying and then walked back out and kept silent. And because in our team, we have a lot of, like, mixed cultures, like a lot of people from different races, they respect us as well and they keep quiet and they let us do our thing.
So in your team, who's the funniest one then?
Asha.
Okay.
What does he do? Why is he funny? What does he do?
Answer Abdul, because he's not intentionally...
You're picking him up all the time, man.
No, he's not intentionally funny. That's the best thing about him.
So he's saying you don't mean to be funny.
You don't mean to be funny, but he just is. That's
what does he do? Give me, name me one or two things. Why is
he just that? Just the stuff he says, it's just out of this world.
Is that true? Come on, man. Why do you think you're so, mashallah? So he's the one who makes everyone laugh.
He makes it, yeah, I'll say.
Who would you name the laziest one or whatever?
Laziest.
Makes Usher.
Slow move, man.
Usher.
Yeah, I think the laziest one in our OC team would be Usher. I think we...
Yeah, we said that live on TV. That's
what we said.
Good. So who's your manager? Hasaba, are you the manager of the team? Or
no, I'm the captain and I train the guys.
Oh, mashallah. So I want something from him. So he's a trainer, as a trainer. And tell me one negative and positive about him. He's here, so you could say.
One negative is he shouts a lot. But then again, that is a positive because...
It's like mom and daddy, they all shout a lot. You know?
But then it motivates us to do better. And obviously that helps the whole team morale and everything else.
Okay.
I'm going to shout less at you.
Something he doesn't know about him. Something he doesn't know about him. Something, a quality or something he doesn't know about him, like, but he is amazing.
Passion. Passion. Passion for what he does. I think he does a lot for the team.
I think he knows that one, man.
Commitment.
Yeah, probably does.
He says that every week. Okay. Shouts us
every week. He puts us on the spot.
Yeah, he puts us on the spot.
I know. All right then. I'll let him up. Abubai, can I ask you something? I know you're not married yourself, so I'm going to pull your leg now. Have you saved £50,000 for a marriage? Because in our wedding nowadays are in that level, man. What do you think?
The best term I could think of is matamaram, isn't it? But
how did we go in that far? It's not Islamic at all. Hard to find. Why did we go that far? A lot of young people are suffering.
Nah, I don't know why it's gone that way. Inshallah, you know, I'll find a wife that is all right with a simple wedding.
No, it's not you in here, no. It's about there are people around you, man. They don't. It's nobody. The person who actually pays those money would say, I want to spend that money.
But it's the thing about it is, if you really care that much about spending that money, then why should you care what other people think? It's your wedding, you should get married how you want to get married. But I understand what you're saying, it's that pressure, like, you know, oh, he got married and he wore this, or he got married in this venue, you know, I want to do the same. Or, you know, people grow up watching too many of these movies and these fairy tale weddings and all that kind of stuff, but you know, I can't even remember the last time I didn't go to a wedding that wasn't proper fancy. You know, you probably got.
Do you guys really genuinely worry, like we're going in the wrong direction?
I'd say, yeah. You know, the sooner or later.
Muslim, do you worry?
I don't think about
this. In your age, that would be different, man. Now we're talking about 50. In your age, probably 80.
80k for a wedding.
Whoa. I don't think in about this.
No time. Some people are using. Aeroplane to, you know, a helicopter, isn't it? Yeah. And they're using this and that to get married off, man.
Obviously, it is ludicrous, but at the end of the day, it's like, I don't think about it.
I know, it's everybody's choice.
Yeah, it's what you feel like.
If you have it, spend it. If you don't have it, don't spend it, but don't spoil it for everybody else. Can I ask you what are the opportunities for young people who wants to change their life? They're into bad stuff. It's too late sometimes. Now they want to change their life. What do they do to change? They say you're a funny man, but I've never seen you smile though. Okay, really, you do smile a lot.
Watch.
Yeah, go on. What do you think? What are the opportunities for them? You guys are good guys, man, honestly. For them, give them something.
I think
you can.
Okay, I think we've talked about youth clubs before as well.
Okay. So it's an issue. Youth club is an issue now.
Yeah.
We know we had a lot of them, and now we've got only a few of them.
Yeah,
it's
a
big issue.
In Bow, there is one. So the kids have nothing to do. But if they do have something to do, then they'll come to the youth club and like kind of come together with their mates.
What can we do? Okay, so we're not going to get clubs anymore, right?
Yeah.
So what can we do as a good guys to save the bad ones? What can we do? Imagine there's no clubs anymore. What can we do? Nothing will change. What can we do to change it?
Just
organize events.
Yeah, stuff like that.
Events.
Charities.
Like, okay. If you've got a friend that's going or like out of bounds, then try, you know, like bring him back in, talk to him. Like
we could listen. We always could talk to local mocks and say, look, can we have a session here, please?
Mm.
Yeah.
Good sessions. That could be your
that
club. Yeah, they might allow you to do that.
Yeah.
If you say, look, we'll look after your place. Let us go inside. Let us play cram board and all that stuff, or table tennis and stuff like that. They should allow us. There's no other way, man. We don't have a space. This is a community place. Let's use it. We could pressure them to, you know, let us use that place. Anything for our sisters, because there are a lot of sisters up there watching. You guys doing any trainings for them? Any projects for them?
Triple BCL, so they're like we operate under the same umbrella. You know, they helped us, the team, survive. You know, there were stages where this team might have not existed, but you know, they gave us the little support, the extra push. What they're trying to do is some classes and get stuff for sisters. So like there's a sisters group where they, you know, between age 13 to 19. So triple BCO, if there's any sisters, any mothers that need, you know, age 13 to 19, there's a girls project going on. They're launching it where it'll be like a girls club. So the girls can go, they can talk about their day-to-day issues, anything they're facing in their life or sorry, I was getting a bit carried away.
Cool,
yeah.
I understand. Yeah. That. It's a cool style, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's a rapping style, is it?
It's me punting on the football pitch, isn't it?
Okay, yeah.
But, they're going to have a club where they can go and do their work if they need any help with it. There's going to be, you know, other sisters there that they can talk to.
So you got courses for girls and you got stuff for boys as well.
Triple BCO, yeah, I'm doing it. Yeah.
That's good.
We're looking to do some stuff as well. We had plans about fit class. I don't know if any sisters out there watching, you know, if you wouldn't mind training some of our aunties and elder ladies. Obviously, it's very difficult with you know, Muslim ladies to get like an English man or, you know, non-Muslim to train them, you know, just because of religious belief. But if there is any sisters out there, get in contact with us because, you know, we're looking for someone that can take, you know, them classes. You know, the aunties, my mum and a group of friends were around the house.
Is it based on what? Exercise and dieting, all that stuff?
Yoga, sort of things like that. We have an idea of yoga. I've been
what's yoga?
Nah, yoga is like...
Cool, okay, no, I'm just pulling your leg, man. That's cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, all right.
But, yeah, I said it to a group of my mum and her friends. Would you guys like to do, you know, would you like to do yoga? If I could get you a session of yoga. They're like, yeah, why not? Well, give us the space, make sure there's, you know, there's no men, and
inshallah, that's good.
And they said they'll be interested. So,
okay, you also, I thought you're doing a trip to Bangladesh. You're taking the boys to, how many people you taking to Bangladesh, and what's the reason behind?
So we're going to tour in Bangladesh. Obviously, it's our hometown, our home country. There isn't just Bengalis in our team. There is non-Bengalis.
MashaAllah.
You know, there's a mixture. We've got people that have moved into the area. They're renting a flat, you know, like students from Europe.
Okay.
They've seen us on a Sunday. What are you guys doing? Oh, we're going to play football. They're like, can we come? And then, you know, we say, yeah, come. You're welcome. You join. But we want to go and, you know, you give that opportunity. When you go to Bangladesh and you play football, there's going to be 10 to 15,000 people going to come watch you. Mm. And plus the teams we're going to go play against, it's a good opportunity for them. You know, say you're a young Bangladeshi kid. Yeah, you haven't got much money or anything, you know. And then for you to be able to say a team from London came and yeah. I played against them. It's a good opportunity for us, don't get me wrong.
How many people have you taken?
25 people.
MashaAllah, a big number, man.
Yeah,
and it's a mixed group, you said?
Mixed group, so young, so as young as these guys. Muslim, I think, be the youngest, 16 years old. If with this under 18, it's a bit tricky because the parents' permission, but all these boys' parents, they know us, so it will be all right with them. So Muslim is going to be the youngest that's going to be going. And then we go all the way up to like the senior players, are like myself, 26 years old, a few other people.
How long are you going for?
We're going to go for 2.5 weeks, inshallah.
Okay.
Play 4 to 5 games. The date.
So where are you going to stay? Are you going to do your camping, or are you going to stay in the hotel, or what?
We're going to stay in the hotel.
Okay.
But
cool, Masum. You're safe, man.
Obviously, we're still working on it. You know, it costs a lot of money to do things like this. So, you know, we're getting funding off people like privately, you know.
Oh, that's good, man. That's cool. So what are the target? What's your target? So you're taking kids to learn Bangladeshi cultures and meeting people, and when they come, of course, they will appreciate a lot of things. Also, you are giving something to Bangladesh itself. The ideas, the how you play and the way you play. It's cool.
It's just that, you know, some of the young people, you go Bangladesh, but, you know, we all got nice bushes and nice buddies and all that. But you never get that chance to go and explore.
That's true, man.
But this is the tour. It's not just going to be football. You know, we're going to go tour. We're going to go look around. We've got like a Jamaican player on our team. We've got an Indian player on our team. We've got a guy from Gibraltar. We've got a Scottish guy, Elliot, if he's watching. I find it hard to understand him sometimes, but
he's
a lovely guy. Yeah, all these guys are going to go. So, you know, they're going to see the cultures in Bangladesh, you know. It's going to be a change. We want to show them that as well. We want to show, come and see this side of Bangladesh. You know, people say, oh, these poor people. But come and see how nice their life
it's
is.
It's an amazing place.
It's a simple life. Such an amazing place. A lot of the young boys won't have been to Desh as well. So it'll be some of their first time.
Yeah, because, you know, like I've myself been to Teknaf, Rangamati, and other places. Chotogra, amazing place. What we do is we just go Bari and come from Bari to home and back to London.
Have you guys heard of any of those places?
It's amazing. Yeah. You would be shocking, man. It's amazing. I've done a trip for, religious trip actually for 4 months. And I walked from Teknaf to Dhaka. It took me 4 months, but it was amazing. I met amazing people. SubhanAllah, it's amazing.
4 months walk?
Yeah, man. So that changed my lifestyle. It changed my life. But it's an amazing place to go and see.
4 months walking.
Yeah. I know it sounds like a mountain man. Okay, Masum, what's your expectation when you go to Bangladesh?
I don't know. This is my first time ever being in Bangladesh.
Really?
Yeah.
You speak Bangla well?
Mm-hmm. No.
Really?
Not properly like that. But yeah, so obviously, I don't know what to expect, to be honest.
Okay, when you watch a Bangla TV, Bangla news or anything, do you understand them?
No.
Really? That's normal. I'm not saying
I understand my mom, but that's okay.
You didn't say nothing about your mom.
That's the basics. She wouldn't speak that complex Bengali with me because she knows that I won't understand it. So.
But this is the real case, honestly. You guys are honest. I'm going to ask you now. Because actually, I'm not Bangla, not 100%. We do up to probably 50 and go along with it, all right? Because they're normal words, isn't it? Bakiren. That's everyone knows that.
Did you understand
but
that?
these are normal things. But when you speak in Shuddha Bhasha and everything, I think it's difficult to understand those things.
That's when we struggle, yeah.
But amongst like any, it's really my age group, that generation, are finding difficult. Then I can't say, I've been English. Same thing, isn't it? You're here for 20 years. You don't speak English. I'm born here. I'm 16, but I don't speak Bangla because I'm not into that environment itself. So we need to, like, when you go to masjid, the khutbahs in, do you understand the khutbahs? If it's not in English, in Bangla?
No, I don't understand. I don't
That's the real thing. We need to find a way, man. Do you understand anything in the khutbah?
No, only if it's in English.
Yeah, certainly. Oh, okay, yeah. Same as you. You've been to Bangladesh, so you speak Urdu, don't you?
I've studied with Urdu and Arabic. But yeah, I think I understand Bengali, sorry. I think it's all right. Just like speaking is a bit hard, but understanding the basics is alright.
Okay, what's your expectation if you go into Bangladesh? What's your expectation from that trip?
I think I've already been there 4 times. So okay, I don't expect nothing new, but actually I do. Obviously I'm going with a group of people now. I'll get to, I don't know, kind of see the inner Bangladesh.
Because you're taking people from outside as well. You're taking Jamaican brothers, you're taking brothers from Scotland, stuff like that. You've got to give them the best tour of their lifetime. They're going to come back and say good thing about you. That's your duty now, isn't it? So you're taking them there. So you need to plan out where you're going to take them, what kind of food you're going to give them, and are you going to give them the knife and fork, or are you going to give them two fingers to eat? What are you going to do? So you guys going to plan it out, man, best.
Yeah.
Okay, what's your expectations, sir, from Bangladesh trip?
Sure.
Can you do shopping say they send you, Abu send you to the shop, local shop, on the
Khoros
Khuri
Riyal? Nah, I just been Bangladesh recently.
So you know how it works.
Yeah, I know how everything works, but just go with the flow.
Okay, good. Any of you guys do rapping?
No, Hassan does.
Hassan does rapping?
Yeah,
oh my God, I can't believe it. Really?
No, when I was young, I did a little bit. Not anymore.
Can be at the Nick somewhere.
Oh, good. And, okay, I think we...
Masoom sings a bit of Nasheed as well.
Oh, Nasheed, okay.
Yeah, but I can't do it now because Hassan, so...
Well, Hassan, do you know one line?
For rapping?
Yeah, one line, come on.
Nah.
No, you don't want to do it. No, he's worried he's going to get married, man. He's worried now. I don't want to spoil my chance.
Yeah, nah, I think I'll stick to no rapping.
Cool.
Now, can I give a shout out to my mates?
Sure.
My girls' mates, a few of them that's been with me since I was in nursery.
Why are you being emotional, man?
Just chill, man.
Yeah,
grew up with them, playing football with them.
Yeah, sure, of course.
Inspiring each other. Salah, Armin, Salim.
Give them a wave then.
A shout out to you lot.
Yeah, sure.
Helping me become who I am. That's it.
Are they the same age as you?
Yeah.
You know what? You just made me emotional, man. Mashallah. I'm glad you mentioned those names. Particular person you want to say anything to? You want to shout out to anyone? They're probably watching you.
Probably one of my closest friends, Lukman. Because he's obviously a good footballer himself, and he always tells me to be the best footballer I could do. So he's like, he would always push me to my limits.
So he's the best friend,
yeah? Who am I talking about before?
Okay.
No.
Had your own discussion.
Okay. Listen, can I ask you something? And you did talk about your parents as well. I think this is something that's so important to talk about. We've only got 5 minutes to wrap it up. If you want to have a happy life, that's the bottom line. We have to be happy at home. And you can't, it's not up to one person, it's up to everybody. Everybody needs to play a role. Be a happy person. One thing I saw is like when we were young, actually, I don't know if you can make tea, coffee, anything. We don't do anything. Boys don't do anything, man, at home. We expect our old mother to do everything. Or if it's a Babi and Babi does it, and I don't know, she's annoyed. But we expect they to do everything. I'm just like, what am I doing, honestly?
Yeah.
At home, we all need to play a role. Oh, if the dad is really rough and, angry man, I need to play a role somewhere, man, to make that even closer. Otherwise, it is an issue. So, do you guys know how to do your sati, anything? Do you guys make it yourself? No, really?
Yeah.
Do you make it yourself?
Yeah.
Do you make it for your mom?
Yeah, if she asks and she wants it, then I'll make it.
If you haven't, honestly, we should. Honestly, you don't know how difficult it is to cook, man, honestly. Everyone likes this, oh, he likes that, or he likes dry, or he likes this, or he likes that fish. Pleasing everybody,
it's hard.
And that for that mom, it's so difficult. If you haven't done it, you try. But like, can I make a tea for everyone? Imagine you got 10 people in the room and you'll see what they say. One will say, Turadio, Sini, Azanokhaba, Sini Diona, you're going to get mad. Asking 10 people their opinion, you're going to get mad. And that, imagine that our parents, how much effort they put. It's amazing. So if I ask you, have you ever said to your mom or dad, that I love you, or me if not balafai, or in that level, because if you go to, you don't have to say here. Listen, honestly, if you look into other communities, as soon as they go out of the room, love you, mom, and then he's gone to school. Love you, dad, it's gone. It's so amazing. Honestly, to be honest with you, we're not doing it, and none of our sister, the brother, they're not learning it.
Yeah.
And no one does it. Our parents also, tarasho me, oh. you've done something well, or you've done something good, we don't even say that as well. Well done, or thank you, or we don't even use those words. I think we should start doing that, honestly.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Us, we show it, we love them.
We don't say it. It's difficult, actually. So if I ask, we're going to only go 5 minutes. Masul, would you like to start with someone, say your mom and dad, like you really like something about them?
They're just really
10 seconds.
Look at the camera. Tell them.
I don't know. They're just really good people. Like they can't, you can't really go wrong with them. They'll always try to see the good in people. That's what I like.
Can you say, "Mom, I love you"?
Mom, I love you.
No, that's great. I mean, it doesn't matter. We do. Honestly, we do. Wallahi, we do. I do. But is it difficult to say in the face? It's sometimes difficult, but because you're not used to it.
It's because it's become that
way
now.
Yeah. 10 seconds for you, sir. Would you like to say something to your parents? Anything?
Of course, I love both my parents. I think I wouldn't change nothing about them. They brought me up to be a good child, I think.
Alhamdulillah. Young man, your turn.
Mom, I love you. Dad, I love you.
Oh, mashallah.
I'll make you cry one day.
They must be very proud of you, brother. Honestly, they must be very proud of you.
That's Hassan's turn. Go on,
Hassan's turn.
He's going to be with his best.
Hassan's going to wrap it up, man. Go on, Hassan, your turn.
Yeah, I think I don't do enough. I'm going to make a promise to my mom. I'm going to give her a hug every day from today.
Jeez.
Cute.
Well done, IQRA. Yeah. I got you going.
I'm going to give a hug to my mom. You're right, though. We don't do enough. I'm going to give a hug to my mom every day. I love you, mom. I love you, dad. I love my whole family, to be honest. That's about it. I don't think I've said love that much in one sentence.
Inshallah.
But, yeah.
No, you guys made my day, man, honestly. So, my two boys, actually, Hashir Muda, I want to do something for you. আমরা সবে আসলে এটা করতে হবে আমার বাচ্চাদেরকে যদি ভালো কিছু কাজ করে আমরা আসলে উই শুড অ্যাপ্রিশিয়েট অ্যান্ড উই শুড শো দেম হাউ মাচ উই লাভ দেম আমরা আসলে বলতে আসলে সবসময় ফেসে থাকি আপনার আমরা যদি বড় যারা আসিরা না করি তাহলে ছোটরা কিলা করবো আপনার আলহামদুলিল্লাহ দ্য ইয়ং গাইজ আর সেড দে লাভ দ্য প্যারেন্টস অফকোর্স উই অল লাভ আওয়ার প্যারেন্টস অ্যান্ড অলসো উই লাভ আওয়ার কিডস অ্যাজ ওয়েল আমরা যদি কোনো কিছু ভুল বলে থাকি দয়া করে আপনারা খুব নজরে দেখবেন অ্যান্ড ইনশাআল্লাহ Next week, we'll try to bring something better as well, just like today. I'm sure it was very learning for everybody as well. So, amader jonno dua korben, inshallah, and stay happy and see you next week, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.